So very good morning to all of you. Today we are going to do another writing skill, that is speech writing. What is speech? Speech is just to express your viewpoints, your opinions on any specific topic. Okay. Suppose you are standing in morning assembly and Women's Day is there, or Independence Day is there, or this Republic Day is there. Suppose you are the head boy of the school and you have been told to deliver a speech on a specific event or any specific occasion. So what you do, you just express your opinions, or you express your feelings or thoughts or your viewpoints regarding that particular topic. So it is given in public. Speech, you give it in public. You cannot give speech to yourself or to your family members, right? So it is given in a gathering. It can be gathering of any type. Suppose you are sitting in a conference, you are in the school, because you people are very small. So I'll give you the example from the viewpoint of a school only, right? Like in morning assembly, a student is given duty to deliver a speech on any specific topic. Right here, I have taken the example that you are head boy of the school and you are to deliver a speech on role of women. So that we will just see later. So what is speech? Speech is to give your opinions or deliver your thoughts or deliver your viewpoints in the public. That is known as speech. Speech means बोलना, जो हम चीज बोल के कहते हैं. As you can see in the image, a lady is standing on the dais and she is delivering the speech, right? Now, what is speech writing? That speech that you want to deliver in the public, when you give it a form of writing, when you just jot it down or you just pen it down in your exams, right? Because it is a part of your writing skill. In section B, in writing skill part, you get a question of speech writing, right? So you are given a topic to deliver a speech, to write a speech, sorry, not to deliver, but to write a speech on any given topic. Suppose a situation is given to you, you are head boy of the school, write a speech on role of women, right? So speech is written to express your views in public. Suppose, how will you write a speech? As you are going to deliver a speech in public, from the same point of view, you will write it down in your paper, on the paper, okay? You will imagine yourself that you are standing in morning assembly, you are standing on dais, and you are going to deliver the speech. The way you will deliver the speech, in the same way you will write it down. You will jot it down in the same way. So present tense is usually used while writing a speech. Okay. So which tense you have to use? In 90% of time, 90% of the cases, in most of the times, you use present tense. Okay. Now, it is very simple to write and it is really very scoring, but the need is to just have a little knowledge about that topic. So your speech writing is divided into three paragraphs. It is divided into three paragraphs. Like you can see on your slide, para one, introduction. In para number one, you will give introduction, and para number two, you will give the main content of the topic, that is known as main body. And this part consists of maximum words, because you are going to express your view on in second paragraph. So it will contain maximum words. And para three, it will just include conclusion. So as you can see, para one and para three, they will be short. They will be shorter as compared to paragraph two. Paragraph two will contain maximum words and paragraph one will be short. Paragraph three will be short, because you are just going to give the introduction and you are just going to conclude the topic. Okay. So I'll be explaining all the three paragraphs one by one. So first paragraph, that is introduction. So in this paragraph, what you will do? First of all, you will greet the audience. Greet means you will wish them, good morning or whatever the time is, or introduce yourself. Or along with greeting them, you can introduce yourself. And after introducing yourself, you will introduce the topic first. Okay, you cannot directly come to the topic that you just start delivering your speech on the given topic. It is very much important to introduce it first. Okay, I have given the example. I have written the example. So just let's read it. Respected principal ma'am, teachers, and my dear friends. Here you can wish them also. You can say them, good morning, everyone. Good morning, respected principal ma'am, teachers, and my dear friends. And after that, as I already told you, situation is that you are the head boy of the school. So you will say, you will introduce yourself. See the second point. First, you greeted the audience with this line, respected principal ma'am, teachers, and my dear friends. After that, introduce yourself means I am Himal, the head boy of the school. Okay, so this is your introduction that you told your name and you told your designation also. After that, the third point is introduce the topic. So there can be many ways to introduce the topics, but what I have written, just see it. I am delighted to have this golden opportunity of expressing my views on the role of women on the eve of Women's Day. For example, it is Women's Day and you just want to express your views on the topic role of women, right? So this would be your first paragraph containing greeting the audience, introducing yourself, and introducing the topic. It will contain 15 to 20 words only. It should not be a longer one, okay? Now coming on to the paragraph number 2, that is the main body or the main content of your topic. So see what it will contain. It will contain some facts. It can contain some data. It can contain some relevant examples. This is very much important to give relevant examples to make your speech interesting. And ask questions. Beta, it is not to ask question in reality. It is just to raise the question to create the, to develop the interest of the audience. It is not there that you are going to get any answer from the audience. You are not going to get any answer from the audience, but it is just to make your speech interesting. You can raise a kind of questions in between. Okay. Next is explain your topic in detail. That is very much important. That in this paragraph, it will contain 80 to 100 words. Your paragraph 2 should be of 80 to 100 words. 80 words are compulsory to write because you are going to explain the topic in detail. And for explaining it in detail, you must write something good in it. Okay. So you must have a knowledge on the given topic. So it is very much necessary that you should develop your reading skills also. You must read some magazines. You must read some newspapers. You must read stories about different personalities. And you must read any other, reading material, whatever you like. Any general knowledge book, whatever you like, you must develop your reading habits. In order to improve your writing skill, it is very much important to improve your reading skills. Without reading, you cannot be perfect in writing. Perfection cannot be there unless and until we are going to give it, we are going to make it a habit. Okay, so it should be in your habit. Kindly inculcate these habits in yourself. The habits of reading, the habits of listening to the good stories, the habit of reading about different personalities, the habit of reading general knowledge books, and most importantly, habit of reading newspaper. Newspapers are delivered to each and every home nowadays. So you can just have English newspaper at your home. You can read 2 or 3 paragraphs daily. You can devote 15 minutes to it. You can keep a dictionary with you so that you can find out the meanings of different words. You need not to ask these words from anyone, from your elders, from your parents. No, it is not required. You can keep a dictionary with you. You can yourself find out the meanings of these words. Only then you can improve your reading skill. And you will be surprised to see when your reading skills are improved, your writing skill be automatically will be improved. Okay? It will be improved automatically. You will not even get to know about it ki hamari writing skill itni achhi ho gayi hai. Jab aap mein wo ek reading एक पढ़ने की हैबिट आप में पढ़ने की लत होनी चाहिए कि वॉट एवर इज रिटन इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू यू मस्ट हैव अ हैबिट ऑफ रीडिंग दिस यू एंटर योर स्कूल रीड ऑल द बोर्ड्स जितने बोर्ड्स आपके स्कूल में हैं वॉट एवर द नोटिसेस आर पेस्टेड ऑन नोटिस बोर्ड यू मस्ट हैव दिस हैबिट ऑफ रीडिंग ऑल दीज थिंग्स ओके सो आई वॉज टॉकिंग अबाउट पैराग्राफ 2 सो दिस विल कंटेन द टॉपिक इन डिटेल सी I told you that you must include some facts, some data, some examples, right? But it will vary from topic to topic. It is not necessary that all the speech writings will contain the same thing. No, it will vary from topic to topic. Now, my topic was role of women. So how would I start my second paragraph? See, gone are the days when women considered themselves weaker. Today, they are neither weak nor inferior, right? So it is a kind of a fact here. Yes, this is a fact. Firstly, in previous times, women were not considered to be strong. They were considered as weaker strata of the society. They were not considered to be as par as men. So it is a fact that ki wo din chale gaye. Gone are the days means wo din chale gaye. When women considered themselves weaker, today they are neither weak nor inferior means they are not inferior to men. First, in previous times, in traditional times, it was assumed that the women are inferior to men. But nowadays in modern society, it is not there at all. They have proved their worth. उन्होंने अपने आप को प्रूव किया है अपनी काबिलियत को प्रूव किया है Name any field of progress wherein they haven't left their mark. See, the kind of asking questions. See, this is where my cursor is. I told you to ask question. Here I have raised a question. Name any field of progress wherein they haven't left their mark. But you are not going to get any answer of this question. You are just raising this question in order to develop, in order to create the interest of your audience. Okay? They are known for their sincerity, sensibility, and hard work, right? Now, I told you to give some examples. So here I have taken some examples. Women like P.T. Usha, Kalpana Chawla, Sania Mirza have made our country proud. And you would agree with me on this point. Now, explain your topic in detail. Now you can write anything on role of women, whatever you know, but it should be in a good way. I mean, it should create the interest of the reader, of your checker, of your teacher. It should, I mean, kya kehte hai, dhyan khinchna, it should drag their attention. Whatever you are writing, it should drag your teacher's attention towards your writing. Okay. Next is, women are the pioneers of nation. Women are now self-sufficient, well-aware, and financially independent. They have attained immense success in every field, whether it is sports, science, education, politics, or academics. Name any field where they haven't left their mark. So, no field is there where they haven't proved their worth. Okay. So, next is women. Are now marching side by side with men in every walk of life. Earlier, women were seen only as housewives who were projected to cook, clean and take care of their families. आप agree करोगे कि पहले women का role क्या था? खाना बनाना, सफाई करना, घर की देखभाल करना, etc. But today, along with handling tough clients at office, they successfully multitask at home too. Means office में तो जो वो clients को handle करती हैं, there are different kinds of clients in front of them. Some are very tough, and how to pursue them, how to influence them, and how to उनको कैसे आपको किसी point पे लेके आना है. How can you make them agree on your point? This is the toughest task for the women, but they are just efficient to do all the tasks efficiently, and they successfully multitask at homes too. Now they are doing their household chores with that efficiency. They are multitaskers. Women are more focused and have a unique decision-making power in the most optimal manner, and at times are in a better position than men. Or sometimes, so what happens? They are more efficient than men. They have proved themselves in many fields that they are better than men in some fields. Men, they can just handle their outside jobs. They cannot handle household chores. But women, they have proved that they are efficient in both the things. They are as good in outside jobs as they are good in household chores. Okay? So this is your paragraph 2. Next, coming on to paragraph 3, that is conclusion. Paragraph 3 is conclusion. So conclude the topic in one or two lines and thank the audience also. Yes. Now you are to conclude the topic, but it should not contain more than one or two lines. But and thanking your audience is very much important. Without thanking the audience, you cannot finish your speech. Okay. So see paragraph 3, how I have concluded my paragraph. I acknowledge the vital role the women play in our society and their immense contribution in shaping and creating the definition of this era. I therefore would like to salute them. See, the concluding lines of my third paragraph, they automatically show that I'm going to conclude my speech. Right? You would not say them that this is my concluding paragraph, but your lines should be like that. It automatically gives the impact that you are going to conclude it. Like I have said, I therefore would like to salute them. Means it is automatically showing that you have saluted them. You are going to just finish your speech. No need to write it down that I'm going to finish my speech. You cannot write this line, but it automatically should depict the same thing. Okay. And in the last, thank you everyone for being patient learners. As I already told you, you must thank the audience. Without thanking them, you cannot end your speech, right? So this was all about your speech writing. This is very easy and very interesting one also. And I hope this topic is clear to you. Thank you so much.